Hey guys, appreciate you tuning to my YouTube channel. This week has all been about answering if the defense does this, then I do that. More information on my website, fbcoachsimpson.com. Also have my coaching course out if you're interested in our specific offense, the Gun T RPO, which is what I'm going to be talking about actually today a little bit, is giving you some if-thens when you're running an offensive set. Okay, I use a set I'm comfortable with. You could draw up whatever sets you want to draw up. But here's what I'm using it for the example. So if the defense lines up like this, then I'm going to run that. It's kind of the concept here. So one thing you want to do on any offense you run is anything in sports is number related, I think. It's all about numbers as a coach. How can I give my team more numbers and a better chance for success than the defense has? So the defense is lined up in this look. So if you drew a line from our center that direction, we have, you count our center, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 players on that side of the ball. The defense has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the defense has an extra guy than we do to the strong side. If you go to the quick side, again, you're counting our center. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Defense has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the number advantage is to the quick side in this look. So if I want to go to where the numbers dictated by the defense, I'm going to call a play to this side of the field, to what we consider our quick side of the field. Okay, so that's an if then. The numbers the defense gave me, easy solution, I'll run to the quick side. That gives me a bonus way, I've got an extra player, I can get them all taken care of. However, I don't want the defense to say I can only run quick, so if I still want to run strong, what are some things I can do? So if I still want to run strong, then here's some answers I've got to have. Okay, well, I can decide I can run my quarterback and bring my running back over here to be a lead blocker, because now I went from 5 to 6 and I balanced the numbers. They have 6, I have 6, I'll run my quarterback. Okay, now I'm even. I can take my receiver from over here and go flop and bring him out there. Then I've got to count again, what do the numbers look like? Did that gain me a player, or did they simply roll their defense to gain another player over here? I can decide I want to go motion. So I want to line up like this. So maybe I did the first thing. I lined up a receiver out here. The defense rolled, and I didn't gain an advantage doing that. Okay, well, that didn't work. Well, what's the next thing? All right, well, now why don't we line up like this and then motion our guy over there? It's probably harder for them to roll. Maybe I'll gain a numbers advantage that way. Okay, or I can go back to rule one. They've got less guys over here and run quick. So it's an if-then. When you're calling offensive plays, that's what you're looking for. That's all you can do as an offensive coordinator is get our numbers right. So what's another way I can do that? Well, we run buck sweep. So we can pull this guy from here to there. Okay, but understand that that guy's a player, a problem too. So we can pull a guy, we can shift, or like I mentioned earlier, we can run formations to get the numbers we want. And so it's building in, if the numbers are this way, my answer will be this way. For us, we would probably run to the quick side if we got this look, okay? Or I would go through those other answers that we had, okay? Can I get the numbers right this way? Can I get the numbers right that way? Or a lot of times as a coach, you've got to decide, maybe it's not so much about the numbers or the X's and O's, you know, it's the Jimmies and the Joes, and that kid doesn't want to tackle my kid. Well, I'm not going to count him now in the numbers. And so these are just things you've got to think through as you're calling plays. These are things that I think through as you're calling plays, no matter what offense you run. You're trying to get numbers in your kid's advantage, okay? And you can do that by multiple ways. So hope this helped a little bit. Guys, if you want specific stuff on the Gun T RPO system, I've got a deal coming up here with Roger Holmes on Thursday. We've got a couple seats left. If you're interested in getting in that, I'm going to talk about our if-then answers with buck sweep. We'll go through our series play and go through our adjustments on how we run that. Roger will be talking about tackle trap and some other wing T-based deals. If you're interested, you can sign up at my website, fbcoachsimpson.com. Appreciate your time.